Descent of Woman, Elaine Morgan claimed that humans once lived, ate, and reproduced in water. She believed that this aquatic phase was the missing link in our past. Like sea mammals, but unlike all land mammals, we developed an insulating fat layer and lost most of our hair. The hair that did remain appears to follow the flow of water as it passes over our bodies. While the hair on the head would have provided a handhold for the infants to cling onto. And if they let go, that was no problem. They could hold their breath underwater or float on the surface. The difference in the amount of fat may be slight in human adults, but in babies, it's marked. Unlike all other primates, which are born with almost no body fat, human babies are born with plenty of it.
Fat is a specific evolutionary development. It's not just a punishment for eating too much. A human child spends longer in the womb than a chimp does, and the whole of the last month is spent accumulating fat. And after it's born, it gets fatter and fatter and fatter for the whole of its first 12 months on Earth. There must be some good reason to this.
And Elaine Morgan thinks there is. Fat does something more than insulate. It provides buoyancy. And if we did have an aquatic past, this ability to float with ease may be the reason for all that baby fat. There's another odd thing about humans, breath control. For land mammals, the lungs pump the way the heart beats, unconsciously. But humans, like aquatic mammals, can make this process conscious if they want to. They can estimate how much breath is needed for a dive, and how long they need to hold it. That makes humans able to do what no other primate can, control precisely the flow of air over a voice box. So a former life in the water could even explain the evolution of language. Humans stand up and they speak.
When you think of the dozens of different ways in which we differ from the other apes, the way we breathe, the way we look, our skin, the way we walk, these cannot all be accounted for by saying they cross open spaces of grass between the trees. Most of these features have parallels among aquatic animals. I believe they've passed through a period of living in a semi-aquatic environment, and this is what set us on the road to becoming fully human.
difference in the amount of fat may be slight in human adults, but in babies, it's marked. Unlike all other primates, which are born with almost no body fat, human babies are born with plenty of it.
Fat is a specific evolutionary development. It's not just a punishment for eating too much. A human child spends longer in the womb than a chimp does, and the whole of the last month is spent accumulating fat. And after it's born, it gets fatter and fatter and fatter for the whole of its first 12 months on Earth. There must be some good reason for this.
And Elaine Morgan thinks there is. Fat does something more than insulate. It provides buoyancy. And if we did have an aquatic past, this ability to float with ease may be the reason for all that baby fat. There's another odd thing about humans, breath control. For land mammals, the lungs pump the way the heart beats, unconsciously. But humans, like aquatic mammals, can make this process conscious if they want to. They can estimate how much breath is needed for a dive, and how long they need to hold it. That makes humans able to do what no other primate can, control precisely the flow of air over a voice box. So a former life in the water could even explain the evolution of language. Humans stand up and they speak.
When you think of the dozens of different ways in which we differ from the other apes, the way we breathe, the way we look, our skin, the way we walk, these cannot all be accounted for by saying they cross open spaces of grass and trees. Most of these features have parallels among aquatic animals. I believe they've passed through a period of living in a semi-aquatic environment, and this is what set us on the road